of introduction here. For a few months, I taught spoken word poetry in a school in Myanmar to a group of very bright students. And while we eventually learned how to write poems in English and express ourselves in English, our everyday conversation and fluency of ideas was limited by language. They spoke Burmese, I spoke English, we couldn't find a common ground, but here we found poetry. When I think about the future of humanity, I think about a world where we, as a community, are not limited by our histories or language or culture. I see it as a group on a whole, where we are moved and we are pushed by empathy more than anything. The poem I'm going to perform, it's called On Learning a New Language. The woman at the grocery store greets me with a smile that touches her eyes every time. I do not know her name, nor does she know mine, but we would like to if we knew how. In my clumsy gestures, I ask her to weigh in onions, tomatoes, add a bag of potatoes, and maybe some sprouts. A lot is said in those 3 minutes. She compliments my dress by gently rubbing her hands over my sleeves. She grins confusedly when she picks up lemons when I hold imaginary eggs in my hand. We talk about the weather by rolling our eyes to the sky. We talk about the men in our lives the same way. In small towns where nothing ever happens, the sky changes color 8 times a day. Here, weather is not small talk. Here, it fills the silence at the dinner table, occupies space at the courtyard every morning where we soak in the sun, extend our arms to compare our tans, and reach out for a hug, but never a metaphor. We braid each other's hair during meditation. We do our dishes quietly while the spoons clatter. We gossip, and every mean word is uttered in whisper like a prayer. Words are redundant with people you're over-familiar with, they say. Every hello is a hiccup stuck in your throat. Every how are you are not on your tongue. A tongue too foreign for your mouth. A mouth too foreign for your body. Grooving to Justin Bieber songs. A song that you memorize like a lover's eyes. The lover is a language your mother cannot sing in. A language you may learn how to write poems in, but never describe your home in. So we learn our own language, wherein we remember each other from the sound of our laughters, our sweaty handshakes, our spines and the lack of it, wherein we call ourselves poets by the way we drag our feet against the floor, the way we cry over a heartbreak, the way we hold and let go at the same time, where you hold the world in your wordlessness, worselessness. What is the word for, I want to go homelessness. Sometimes I wake up too late for class and it is another day I must go hungry. Sometimes there is a meal sneaked in on my table, kept quietly because I did not learn how to say I need to fix my lock in Burmese. Thank you. I want to follow this up with two poems written by two of my favorite students in Myanmar where I was teaching. And they are some of the brightest, most sensitive, most motivated students I've ever come across. And I'm here, I'm speaking, I am reciting poetry today because they have given me the privilege of teaching them and the experience of knowing their stories. So the first one is about love by this boy called Toyong, who knows how to love a lot and is sad that people don't love him back a lot. And this poem is called Love. What is love? Love is not a choice by a chance. I don't promise the king of day's sun. I don't promise the queen of night moon, but I promise I will be there for you. I can't protect you from the darkness of difficulties, but I promise you, you will never face it alone. Love is like poetry. First, you learn the rules. Then you forget the rules. Finally, you write from your heart. And the second one is by Soot Ong, who is another very sensitive, very mature boy. He's just 19 years old, and I wish he was there to perform this himself because he's also an exceptional performer. This one's called Bucket List. Listen to the parents and teachers, do the homework and get number one in class. Follow the rules and the society. Be the person who all society love. I dreamed that when I was a child. Attend the famous university. Try to be as smart as I can. After that, I will go to the big city. Find the job which gets money a lot. I dreamed that when I was young. Buy a big house and special car. Journey all over the world. Marriage with the person I love. Be the person most people want. I dreamed that when I was a teenager. My life was full with imagination. By living in the past and in the future, mind was full with ego, did not focus about happiness and love, being the slave of others. Now I understand what my bucket list is. Life is not a destination, it is a journey. Live in the present moment, do the things I want, eat slowly, kiss slowly, forgive quickly, and be happy. Thank you.